In this video, we will review how to troubleshoot a Samsung LED TV that won't turn on and does have standby. In Samsung LED TVs, you can have differences in the number of boards. Most will have a main board and a power supply board, while some may have an LED driver board and TCON board. This TV just has a main board and a power supply board. Here is the main board. And here is the power supply board. The LED driver can sometimes be built onto the power supply board, as we can see here on this TV. The TCON board can also sometimes be built onto the main board or into the TV panel. This TV has the TCON board connection here, and then it runs into the panel. Click the link in the video for more information on the basic functions of these boards. If you cannot power on your TV, the first thing you will want to check is that you have the TV plugged into an outlet that is working. After making sure that the outlet is working, you will want to check and see that your TV has a standby light. The standby light will typically be blinking or illuminated on the front of the TV. If your TV will not power on and you do have standby, then the problem is most likely with either the power supply or the main board. The first thing you can do is to visually inspect the main board and power supply, looking for damaged components. Here we have a close-up of the power supply. You can look over the board and do a visual inspection, looking for any raised or puffy capacitors or any burnt or damaged components. Here are some examples of what a puffy capacitor or burnt and damaged component will look like. If you have any damaged components that look this way, you should replace the board. If there is not a replacement board available, you can also try replacing the individual components or purchasing a repair kit. Removing and installing new components requires the ability to be able to solder. When looking for damaged components or burn marks, you can also look at the bottom side of the board. You would simply just need to disconnect all the cables and then remove the screws that hold the board to the panel. Be sure when disconnecting cables and removing screws that you take a picture of what the board looks like in the original state with all the cables connected, and then you'll have a reference for when you reconnect all the cables. Here's a close-up of the main board. You can look over the board and do a visual inspection, again looking for any damaged components. If you have any damaged components, then you should replace that board. If you do not see any damaged components, the next step would be to check voltages on the power supply and the main board. If you do not have the skills or tools to check voltages, but still want to try and fix your TV, you could also replace the power supply and main board one at a time and see if one of those two boards fixes the problem. If you are going to purchase multiple boards and replace them individually to see if one of the boards fixes the problem, before purchasing, be sure to understand the return policy of the company you are purchasing from, as there may be restocking fees for any returned parts or parts that are not returnable at all. Here are some other videos that can help with troubleshooting Samsung LED TV repair. Thank you for watching our Samsung LED TV repair video for Samsung LED TVs that will not power on but do have standby. If you have any further questions regarding your repair, simply post a question in the comment section below. We strive to learn and share new TV repair tips every day. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and grow with us. Share our videos with your friends to help us spread the savings. And don't forget to hit that like button.